What's up, gang? Back here in the dungeon with a bit of a different flair for you. This is 13 of my favorite horror flicks from when I was born until today. So nothing prior to 1971. Yeah, I'm getting kind of old. So no really black and white, universal, my favorite type of stuff. You know me, I love that black and white stuff, but this is from current day to 1971. My 13 favorite horror flicks. I want to hear what yours are, so please comment down below. And hey, let's get it started. So, starting off at number 13, it has to be Friday the 13th, but it's part three. The first 3D movie that I saw in the movie theater was actually part three, and that's when Jason got the hockey mask, and that was that was 1982. So it takes it back a bit, but you know, that was a serious, serious good movie. So number 12, also from 1982, was Creepshow, based on the comic. And you know, had little mini series that they broke down, and just I thought it was a great thing. I actually had the Creepshow magazine from that movie. So number 11, bit of a not crazy horror, but you know, it's one of those ones that stuck with me. This is 1985, and it's Stephen King's, who Stephen King is going to be featured in quite a few of these for me because I love these movies. But 1985, Stephen King's Silver Bullet, just had some good acting in it with Gary Busey. It was awesome in that movie. And you know, I thought it was a great horror flick. I thought it was a great werewolf movie. I love werewolf movies, by the way. So that's my number 11. Number 10, the classic Wes Craven, A Nightmare on Elm Street. That came out in 1984. And junior high school days. And I thought it was awesome. Johnny Depp was in that movie, if you didn't know. So Freddy is still looking for you, coming to your dream. So number 9, first real zombie movie that I fell in love with was Dawn of the Dead, you know, the one with the shopping mall and the zombies walking around, and you gotta shoot them in the head. That was classic George A. Romero with that one. So number 9, that was 1978. I didn't know that was that old. I thought it was actually out in the 80s, but I guess I caught it a little bit later in my youth, but on Betamax days. So number 8, this one's taking it way back. I mean, I don't remember this when it came out, obviously, because I was like 5 years old. 1976, The Omen, Damien, It's All for You. Classic movie, classic. Number 7, might get a little bit of slack for this one. It's kind of a sci-fi horror, but if you can see back there in the background, that's classic right there. John Carpenter's The Thing, Antarctica, science experiment gone wrong, and the mutation went crazy. Took out the dogs, took them all out, took out Doc. Great movie. So number 6, my first ever drive-in movies back in the day. My Uncle Joe took me to this, to see this in 1980 with my best friend Jerry. And I believe it was at the Elk Ridge Drive-In, which has been long, long gone. But it was a double feature that night. I remember it well. First one was Blood Beach, which was, it was okay movie. But the second and the main movie that we saw kind of like blew us away. It was a foreign flick that they turned into English. And we known this movie as The Gates of Hell, 1980 classic, but it's also known as City of the Living Dead. And it's where a priest hangs himself and opens up the gates of hell. And it was super graphic for me at that age. And I thought it was just an awesome movie. Number 5, here's Johnny, The Shining. You gotta love it. The twins, the bikes, the whole schizo, going mad at the big party, and got snowed in. And you know, Jack, you were a bad boy. But I love The Shining. It had a lot of deep thoughts in it, and a lot of hidden variations of things that just crazy stuff that made people loony. So that's number five, The Shining. Number four, We're Gonna Get You, We're Gonna Get You. Yes, The Evil Dead has to be in the top five, right? The Evil Dead was one of the scariest movies that I've ever seen, and I used to scare the heck out of the kids, my kids, and, you know, it's just one of those classic 1981 films, The Evil Dead, and the sequels were really good as well, but for me, that's in my top five. The number four, The Evil Dead. Number three, this one's probably going to be a hate or love kind of thing, and a lot of people are going to either agree with me or like, you're out of your mind, but this movie to me was super original, and it's based out of here in Maryland. Yes, a dead giveaway now, but it is The Blair Witch Project. Yes, I loved that movie. I thought it was just well done, you know, on a low budget, and just the theory of it was just beautiful. The whole GoPro thing, it's kind of like, you know, the angles that we do when we're out filming these sort of things and live fishing, hunting, on a bike, whatever. That whole thing, all that derived from that movie, if you could believe that. To me, I thought it was just brilliant. So, number three, 1999 classic, The Blair Witch. Number two, and this one is definitely on a lot of people's list for top three, I would think, and it is based out of Texas. Yeah, you know. Hit her, Grandpa. The Texas Chainsaw Massacre, old Leatherface, that whole bunch of crazies down there in Texas making that head cheese. Awesome stuff. My grandmother loved head cheese, by the way, and that's a true fact. Number one, my number one movie, all-time horror classic. Now, number two was up there. I had it, Jaws, but I had to remove that because I thought it'd be a little bit of, you know, controversy with picking something that's not quite a horror movie, even though I thought Jaws is the greatest movie of all times, in my opinion, at least one of them. And it scared the crap out of people, but I removed it to put in Texas Chainsaw Massacre. But my number one is the scariest damn movie that has ever been out there. And I, you know, I think there's a lot of people that will agree with this one. And it is the classic down in Georgetown, D.C. area, The Exorcist. All right, that is my top 13. What are yours? Comment below. I'd like to hear what your 13 from the year you were born until today. Hey, yo, if you're new to the channel, please do this.
Smash, smash, smash.
Appreciate it, man. We'll see you on the next one. You never know what you're going to see on this channel. Horns up.